Hello and welcome everybody to Clannad. Now, this is one of the most famous visual novels there ever were, or at least of the ones I know of. It is made by Key, as you can see in the bottom left corner right here. And I guess that already speaks for itself, because Key is pretty famous for their games. Yeah, I always wanted to play Clannad, and now it was released on Steam, and I thought, yeah, I mean, this is the perfect point of time. I just finished Libretta, so why the hell not? Alright, so let's jump right in. We could, by the way, I'd already checked out a bit of the game, we could rename our character. And to tell you the truth, Okazaki Tomoya is not my favorite Japanese name in the world, especially Tomoya. I mean, Okazaki, fine, but Tomoya, I don't know. But, you know, all just a matter of taste. We'll just keep the name so nobody's angry at me, basically. So, let's jump right in. Now, as mentioned, I have already tried out the game a little bit for setting up audio and stuff. So I played like the first 3 minutes or something. But I'm, you know, just to check the audio for the voice actors, stuff like that. Because actually I had to tune down the voice actors a little bit, because in my recording they would echo like really, really badly. So I apologize for that, but you know, it had to be done. Alright, here we go. The world is covered in white. Snow. Yes, it's snow. Even now it continues to fall, coating me in its paleness. Ah, what could I be doing here? Better yet, how long have I been here? My hand is buried in snow. It's holding on to something. I pull it out. It's a pure white hand. A girl's hand. Oh yeah, that's right. I wasn't alone. I wipe away the snow on her face. A profile, sleeping peacefully, appears before me. Yes, this girl and I had always been together. Here in this world. This empty, sorrowful world. Well, that is already setting up the tune for this game. You know, I've read very different stuff on the internet about Clannad. Most people like say it's the best thing that was created ever. But there are also some people who say it's a tearjerker for tearjerker's sake, you know? And I'm really curious, like, I wanna see if Clannad is as good as the hype indicates. So, let's see. I hate this town. There's just too many memories here I'd rather forget. Every day is the same. Go to school, see friends, come home to a place I can't stand. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will change if I keep living like this. I wonder if my life will ever change. There's nature almost everywhere you look around here. I guess today is just another day of trekking through the mountains to get to school. The trip would be so much easier if I could just level them all. If I were able to go in a straight line, I'd probably save myself 20 minutes. 20 minutes every day. How much time would that save me a year? I try to do the math in my head as I walk. Ah, I can't figure it out. I don't see any other students from my school around. This is the main street to school too. Normally there are students everywhere. Today isn't a vacation day or anything like that either. So I guess that means I'm late. Responsible students don't just stroll into school at this hour of the day after all. Still, I continue walking at a leisurely pace, unfazed by my realization and the deserted scene before me. I mean, when I was late for school, and I actually was like, in the last year of school, I was late quite a few times. I usually didn't hurry. I mean, if you're too late, it doesn't matter if you're like 5 minutes or 7 minutes too late, you know. Probably not a good lesson for all you school kids out there, who probably shouldn't watch all these romance visual novels. I actually don't know if there is graphical content, like sexual content in this visual novel. 200 meters left to the school gates. I stand still for a moment. Ah. I exhale dejectedly while gazing up at the sky. Presented by Key. There stands the school gates, all the way up the ridge. Whose idea was it to put a school at the top of a giant slope anyway? The hill goes on like a never-ending nightmare. There is another sigh, but one much smaller and shorter than mine. I look to my right. A girl is standing there, just as still as me. I can tell from the color of the school insignia on her uniform that she's also a third-year student. But she isn't someone familiar to me. That is highly unlikely, actually. I mean, in my last school year, there were a few people I think I barely ever spoke to be fair. But at least I all knew them. I knew them all. Maybe she's new. Her short hair that comes to just above her shoulders flutters in the wind. She seems to be on the verge of tears. As a repeat offender of late arrivals, I'm not bothered one bit. She, on the other hand, seems far more concerned. The idea of getting to class this late must be pretty upsetting to her. She's nodding her head up and down with her eyes closed, as if telling herself something. Oh, excuse me, I skipped her sighing. Then she opens them. She stares up the school gates. As mentioned, it's not all that loud. But, you know, as mentioned, the problem is otherwise they are echoing like crazy. I don't know, I think it's Bandicam's problem. Like, Bandicam often has trouble with echoes and stuff like that. I don't know why it does that, but apparently it does. So, maybe I should, buy fraps or something in the future. Huh? Oh, she's not asking me. She's talking to somebody else. Someone in her head, I guess. I wonder how he, or perhaps she, replied. That is a really sad way of looking at it. I mean, adult life can be pretty fun too. I try to tell myself that every day. Every day. Every day. That is true. She continues to talk to herself awkwardly. You just have to find more, that's it. The girl looks at me, surprised. It's almost as if she thought she was alone this whole time. Then you just have to find more things that are fun, more things that make you happy. That is all. That can't be too hard, right? Oh, cinematic wind through her hair, and the cherry leaves fly. You know, as commonplace as that is in Japanese media in general, I kinda still like the image. You know, it's something that doesn't get old. The expression on her face, ah yes. I remember those days, what it felt like to be naive, simple. That's something we've all experienced. Come on, let's go. We start to climb the hill. Up to an unpredicted future. The long, long hill. So I assume that will be the first love interest or something. I don't know if there are that many love interests in general. So I played up to this point. And I got a Steam achievement. Sunohara, hi! Wait, no. That ain't me. The teacher calls the student's name. I look to my side where he said Sunohara, right? Not Sunohara. So, I look to my side where Sunohara's desk sits empty. His attendance rate is even worse than mine. You see, the two of us are labeled as the delinquents at school. Oh great, best main character already. But that's probably why we get along so well. He's really the only person in class I can have an honest conversation with. Nevertheless, today's classes begin. I spent them looking out the window. The teacher's voices go in one ear and out the other. Classes finish, bringing the school to an end. so Nohara never did show. In fact, the only person I've spoken to all day is that girl from this morning. Wow, that is sad. That is really sad. It really is just another ordinary day. Since I'm not part of any after-school club, I grab my empty bag, cut through a pack of jabbering students, and leave the classroom. I could go home, but there wouldn't be anyone else there at this hour. Not anyone I'd want to see anyway. You seem like a nice fellow. I don't have a mother. Okay, maybe that explains it. I am very judgmental. Maybe I should first listen and then talk. I was told that she died in a car accident when I was still little. I don't even remember what she looks like. After her passing, my father sank into a pretty deep depression, probably due to the shock of it all. Using alcohol to numb his pain, he wasted away his days gambling. Because of that, a lot of my time as a kid was spent arguing with him, actually. But one day, our relationship took a turn for the worse. He got violent with me. Ever since then, my father stopped showing his emotions. So do you mean he got violent with you one time, or he's in general violent with you? No matter what, it's bad, I'm just curious. He has also stopped calling me just Tomoya, instead calling me Tomoya-kun, as if we're nothing more than strangers. And indeed, he's turned into just that at this point. It's like he's retreating into some kind of shell, as if he's trying to sever the present from the past. Or sever, not sever probably. Would be better if he'd just push me away completely, or even just keep hitting me. Okay, so he only hit you once. Well man, okay, that's tough. Okay, I take everything back I said. At least then I'd know where I'd stand with him. No. Every time he sees me back home from school, he brightens up like an old friend is visiting and starts making small talk. It hurts. It hurts so much. I can't stand being home anymore. That's why I stay out so late. If I come home when I know he's asleep, I don't have to see him. That's why I go to bed at dawn. Of course, then I don't wake up until noon. I've been late almost every day since starting high school. I've spent my life like this for almost 3 years now. Okay, how are you still in school? But okay. Today is no different either. I go home just to change out of my school uniform, then leave again before my father gets back. The routine practically feels ingrained in me at this point. I wander around town aimlessly until nightfall. No matter what, I always end up at the same place. On my way, I grab some takeout from one of the local restaurants. I carry it with me as I walk down the massive hill from this morning toward the school dormitory. Our school pays special attention to its clubs, so a lot of students come from more rural areas to enroll. Those students then live here for the next 3 years, separated from their parents. These kids are practically members of a different species when compared to someone without any academic dreams like me. Okay. Normally I wouldn't have anything to do with them, but Sunohara lives here. He used to be on the soccer team and was even accepted to the school because of how good he was. However, he lost his spot on the varsity team as a freshman after being suspended for getting into a huge fight with a student from another school. So, okay. To pick that apart, we have the abused child who, lives in kind of a shell with his father who lives in a shell. And we have the probably likable rowdy who fought for something right, but in the end just, used the wrong methods. My prediction. By the time the following year's squad was decided, he was already an outcast within the team. He had no choice but to leave. He doesn't have the money to move though, so he still lives in the dorms where all the jocks are. So Nohara is standing there. He's in front of another room, talking to a student about twice his size. Okay. Wow, you can't afford head. That is actually pretty bad. And that is, on the other hand, not nice.
調子出ないんだよね。
Into the zone?
それに結構イカス音楽だと思うんだよね。
Okay, you are the delinquent. Okay, I'm not judging. Maybe you know karate or something. But you don't look that threatening. So you're really like the likable delinquent. A hothead or something.
今度歌詞とかちゃんと聞いてみてよ。イカしてるから。
イカしてるも何もね。
Okay, that was already all.
じゃあ、ムカついてんだよ。次聞こえてきたら叩き出すぞ。
Slam. So Nohara hangs his head, still standing in front of the now closed door. Oh, that was a rugby player. Now, okay, now it makes sense that he is twice his size. Of course, as a soccer player, or football player, however you want to call it, you don't need to be as big as a rugby player. Usually, at least. He mumbles the words under his breath. He won't be able to hear you like that, you know. Damn it! Stupid rugby players! Standing behind him, I repeat his words with a yell. Sunohara grabs my hat and drags me into this room. Well, that is probably more of a rugby technique. Oh, okay. Uh-huh. So it seems like a pretty normal room. Average room for a student, I guess. Manga, CD player, weights. But, you know, not the biggest weights. Oh, and it's 2003. Wow, Clannad is really pretty old. Well, on a visual novel level, I guess. It's not like 2003 is like forever. I can hear angry yells of, "Hey, who's that?" resonating from the hallway. Apparently. You're the one who said it. I wonder what would have happened if I called myself now, I don't know, Kobashi, or I don't know, something. Would he still say Okazaki? Then let's go out with a bang. Oh, you're a year... Huh? Oh, you mean the whole third year, okay. And you're just going to live in fear like this the entire time? Yeah, okay, and you don't have the soccer team. Yeah, that kind of sucks.
Hey!
Great, I'll be sure to take a shot of my own at you while I'm at it. That is not nice. I'm on the rugby team's side, you know. Oh, not now. But I will be when all things go when all this goes down. Boom! The wall shakes. The rumble is followed by a quiet down. I myself shouldn't be actually that loud. It's like in the middle of the night. I'll kick the wall right back for you. You get scared way too easily. He's crying now. Sure. His pathetic display has such an impact on me that I give in without thinking. Munch, munch. I settle down in the small area between the wall and Sunohara's ever-present kotatsu table and begin to eat my dinner. Dangopedia term added, kotatsu. Yeah, I know what it is, but... Okay, I could go look it up, but it's basically like this little table that has a heater under it, or something like this, and you can put your legs under it while sitting at the table, you know? Sorry, could I get some tea? Like, why not? Hey, I said sorry. Why? That's not nice. Ah, okay, he doesn't have tea. Well, okay, then it's a stupid question. We're in your room, I understand that. And you're my mate here. Please, I forgot to buy some. But I thought you wanted to do anything you could to be of service to me after I saved your life. No? That's what you told me after I saved you, though. Really? How did he do that? I wasn't there. That man named Sunohara died long ago. Before you know, he stands your loyal attendant. I am but a simple tea servant. That's what you'll say to me. So, tea please. Alright. Could you just get me one last cup of tea then? Oh, but it's such a moving story. You'll definitely want to purr me some once you hear it. You seemed done after suffering life-threatening injuries. Okay, now I'm really interested in this story. But I, thirsty, ordered you to make me tea. So you summoned up the last drops of your strength to go brew some, even as you growled on all fours. And then... Mr. Okazaki, here is your tea, sir. This cup will be my last. You died with a smile on your face. Yeah. Well, it was exactly how you would wish to go, after all. Okay, I gotta say, like, I think it's well written in the aspect, like, this is some stupid stuff I would talk like with my friends, especially back in the day as well. Nevertheless, I sat there, drinking that final cup of tea as I cried. See, moving, isn't it? So, tea please. Like, come on, what is this even on your table? It's probably tea. Like, maybe it's milk? I don't know. You know the thing next to the water? But why would it... I'm pretty sure it's tea. Like, look at it, it's white and green. Who would sell milk with green on it? Like, it must be tea. Be a nice guy and give me tea. I spent the rest of my time there reading a magazine. With no TV in the room, the only things I can really do are talk to Sunohara or read. It was late, and the date had already changed over. Yeah, I guess so. One line I didn't cross was staying the night in Sunohara's room. Just the thought of waking up in the morning to someone like that is depressing. Okay. Sunohara grabbed some underwear and a towel out from under a heap of clothes in the corner of his room before leaving. I preferred to avoid having to welcome Sunohara back to his room after a shower, so I'll leave while I still can. I close the magazine and get up off the floor. As I do, I find myself looking at a cassette player. There's a tape still sitting inside it. I try playing it. Out comes the melody of a Japanese rap song that hasn't been popular for a while. I wonder if that is real or not. Talk about lame. Who listens to this kind of stuff? Record your own voice over it, just leave it there. So, be a jackass or don't be a jackass. I choose to not be a jackass. Just leave it there. This would make it the first time I don't do anything to his room after he leaves me alone in it, but... Also, hooray, first decision. And not a hard one at that. You know, if you have never seen a Let's Play of mine, I usually play games like... I do decisions the way I would do them in reality. Or at least I try, you know? So, if there are these decisions I know that make me go on a route or something, I still try to decide the way I would actually do. Just so you know. I guess I'll spare him for today. Yeah, also he's your good friend, and he apparently has a tape he likes. Like, why would you, like, talk over it or record over it? Like, that is really bad. Also, this sounds like, the sound's not like rap, the sound's like dubstep or something. And that wasn't really a thing in 2003. Or was it, and I just didn't know. I decide to leave before Sunohara returns. Clannad. April 15th. April 15th. So, that was Sunohara. That was actually interesting. Like, I always like a good friend relationship in a story. Like, in each and every story, it doesn't even matter if it's visual novel, book, or a movie. For example, I love the relationship between Sherlock Holmes and Watson. In War and Peace, my favorite relationships were between the soldiers. It's always one of the most interesting aspects, of course, that has nothing to do with... that has not all that much to do with the main plot. Which I guess the main plot will be evolving around, you know, girls and stuff. At least I assume. So, very interesting character. And also, I feel the friendship's kind of natural. So that's good. She's standing here again, just like yesterday. You again. Why can't you go up the hill on your own? You don't have to tell me if you don't want to. You don't know me, after all. But you really should get to school on time like a good student. She points straight at me, her eyes burning right through my finely veiled reticence. Forget about me. I look away, unable to meet her gaze any longer. What am I doing, acting all serious and getting on her case? I don't know her well enough to do that. She's absolutely right, though. She's just as much of a delinquent as I am. Do what you want. I start up the hill without her. It's just... what drew me to her was the fact that she didn't really look like a bad student. That's all. A voice. It's hers. Oh. Whoops, okay, the game was just stuck for 3 seconds there. I look behind me to find her standing there quietly. Why? It's kind of odd that she's asking me, of all people, someone she doesn't even know. Yeah, I think this is, I can change you dynamic. It's like she's actually a good student who has one problem or the other, and you are actually a bad student who has many problems or the others, and probably she's going to try to change you for a more positive matter. I assume. I mean, she has to have at least a friend or two, right? Or maybe she's more of the lonely kind. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. I look up the hill, squinting from the sun's blinding glare. Ah, it's not too far away, and she's got no one else to go up with right now. I guess it wouldn't hurt. Do what you want. I start walking again after repeating myself. What now? The girl eyes me, looking as though she's deciding on whether to say what has just popped into her head. Then... Anpan. Oh, and once knew what Anpan is. Okay, I forgot. A single word is all that comes out. How should I even reply to something like that? Okay, let's look it up for a second here. Anpan is a sweet roll that is filled with red bean paste. It is commonly offered in Japanese bakeries, supermarkets, and schools. Okay, there we go. That is Anpan. Baguette! You took the words right off my mouth. I was just going to say that to you. So, what? You like Anpan or something? Is that it? Talk about beating around the bush. It's not like I really care either way. Alright, well, let's get going. Maybe she thinks you're like Anpan, you have a sweet core or something. There's a bit of a newfound energy in her response. Maybe that was some kind of weird magical spell she cast just now. Tha-thunk, 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 whatever that means. Her footsteps make it sound like she's galloping behind me. The bell rings, ending the period. Hmm? Someone calls out to me unexpectedly. I turn to face the source. Oh, another new face. Or I guess a familiar face to him, but not to me. Ryo Fujibayashi. Okay, Ryo Fujibayashi. She's the class president, I think. Or rather, she's the girl that was saddled with the responsibility of being the class president. If I remember correctly, she's Kyo's younger twin. Kyo? No, I don't know Kyo. She insecurely darts her eyes left and right, as if she's standing next to my desk. Yeah? She says as she hands me a sheet of paper. A love letter? You are bolder than you look. It's not easy to just hand that to me directly. Ah, come on, don't be so cruel. Especially like, I'm not totally free of bitterness, you know what I mean? I'm not the kind of guy who is just all the time happy and stuff like that. But if I'm cruel, I'm never cruel to people who can't defend themselves. You know what I mean? That is just not fair. Is it a chain letter then? It's kind of mean of you to hand it to me so nonchalantly. A letter of challenge. Thump. Fujibayashi blushes and presses the paper against my chest. Yeah, see how nice she is, you jackass. Oh, lame. Okay, Tomoya. Your life is rough. Okay. You had bad experiences. Okay. Don't be a dick to other people. It's not their fault. I toss it in my desk drawer without so much as looking at it. It's probably nothing important anyway. Hmm? You need something else? That would be an idea. That's no concern of yours, right? So you think you can start picking on your classmates' attendance now that you are the class press? Her eyes start to water. I guess that was a little too much. Apologize, ignore her! I mean, if Tomoya... Oh, first of all, I forgot to save after before the first decisions. Usually I save a lot just so it's easier to replay for new routes, you know? New routes, you know? So of course we apologize. We make Tomoya a good person. I'm sorry, I went a bit too far. Yeah. Well, I mean, it's no reason to cry. Why? Is she a sumo wrestler or something? You can't say that when you are on the verge of tears. In any case, since no tears have actually come out, let's just say she isn't crying. Well, I'll consider it. Hi, ganbaremasu. With that, Fujibayashi takes out a deck of cards from her shirt pocket. Then gently but clumsily, she begins to shuffle the deck. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Clatter. And the cards scatter blandly across the floor. Flustered, she picks them up off the ground and starts shuffling again. She manages to do it this time. Fujabayashi clumsily fans the card out and holds them out toward me. What's this? Should I pick one? Oh, so it's some kind of magic trick, no card game, okay. I have no clue what is going on. Is he trying to show me some sort of card trick? In any case, I take three cards. Here. She stares at the three cards I had chosen. Huh? Are you really fortunate telling now? I can't believe it. Oh my god. Well, to each their own, to each their own. I just think it's stupid. Is he trying to pick a fight? Hey, didn't you just tell me to come on time? What's this about? Hey, nothing, Ryo, but have you met Tomoya? He's not that kind of guy, except when I make him to be that guy. Oh, okay. Wait a second. Why is your fortune so detailed? I wouldn't believe that if you were using tarot cards, much less playing cards. How can you possibly tell all that would happen with just numbers and suits? That seems rather unlikely, but okay. Her sixth sense is in full force, huh? On top of that, she's pretty confident about it. Could it be that you actually don't want me to come to school? And you can change your future. Okay then, I absolutely won't be late tomorrow. Just to prove I were wrong, huh? Even if I come across an old lady in trouble at the crosswalk, I pretend I don't see her. Okay, to be fair, Ryo, you brought this one on your own. Nope, I'll abandon her. Ding dong. There, the bell is ringing. Go back to your seat. Upon me saying so, Fujibayashi heads for her seat with her shoulders dropped. Drooped, not dropped. Sheesh, she's making me feel depressed. I have the feeling it will come true though, one way or the other. She says, and trots to her seat. Maybe she's really trying to pick a fight after all. Having been told such a weird fortune, I am feeling kind of blue. Okay, now this episode is already way over 30 minutes, I think. So, I want to make long episodes just because Clannad is a very long game and otherwise we'll never finish it, I guess. So, very long episodes it is. So far I think it's pretty fun. To be fair, the characters are pretty stereotypical so far. I mean, we didn't have time to really get into the characters. But, you know, there is the clumsy one who's always near the verge of tears. There is, like, the hothead who is actually a nice guy, but it seems in certain situation he's probably a hothead. We'll see that, I guess, in the future. Then we have the delinquent with the bad past who's the main character, who is probably not really a bad guy and will, you know, have the possibility to change him a bit. It doesn't seem like they invented very, very novel characters. But the way they are written, they are still likable so far. And I think the reading experience is enjoyable, at least to me. So I go on playing it. Okay, so thank you everybody for watching. Come back for the next episode. And I'll see you then. Bye-bye.